Hello students, today we are going to start about last session, that is question answer session of this chapter. First question is, list conditions under which combustion can take place. List the conditions under which combustion can take place. Answer is, combustion can take place in the presence of, yes, the combustible substance. Next is oxygen, that is supporter of combustion. Attainment of ignition temperature of the substance. So first condition is the substance that is going for the combustion, that should be a combustible substance. Then it can take the oxygen, that is the supporter of combustion, and then it should attain its ignition temperature as early as possible so that the substance can burn or substance can combust. Okay. Question 2, fill in the blanks. First is, burning of wood and coal causes dash dash of air. Second question is, I am only reading questions, then we'll solve the answers. Then we'll discuss about the answers. A liquid fuel used in home is, fuel must be heated to its dash dash before it starts burning. Fire produced by oil cannot be controlled by dash dash. So first answer is, burning of wood and coal causes pollution of air, because wood and coal, it will produce it has unburned carbon, and that carbon particles emit into the atmosphere, so it will produce the pollution. Then it is not the burning of wood and coal is not a complete combustion, so it will create some gases or a smoke that will pollute the air. So burning of wood and coal causes pollution of air. A liquid fuel used in home is kerosene. Okay. Because at home we have used LPG, that is liquefied petroleum gas. Okay, then petrol and diesel, we not use petrol and diesel in home, we use that in automobile. That's why a liquid fuel used in home is kerosene. Fuel must be heated to its ignition temperature before it starts burning. This we have discussed in our conditions for combustion, that ignition temperature means the lowest temperature at which substance starts burning. Okay, so fuel must be heated to its ignition temperature and then it will start burning. The fire produced by oil cannot be controlled by water. Yes, we have discussed this in our give reason. Then why? Because oil is lighter than water and water is denser. So water gets settled down beneath the oil and oil particles are upside, so it will catch fire immediately. So instead of removing fire, oil support the fire, because oil means fuel, so it has a less ignition temperature, and that's why the fire produced by oil cannot be controlled by water. Next is question 3. Explain how the use of CNG in automobiles has reduced pollution in our country. Explain how the use of CNG, that is compressed natural gas, in automobiles has reduced pollution in our country. So CNG is comparatively cleaner fuel. CNG can be alternative for diesel and petrol because it is compressed natural gas. And why it is used for reducing the pollution, that because it gives out less carbon dioxide gas, and that we all know that carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide and sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide are the major pollutant that will liberate out through the automobiles. So if they come into atmosphere, they will cause the pollutions. Okay, and CNG is cleaner. They cannot liberate such kind of gases in a large amount. Okay, so because it gives out less carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide, and that is beneficial as they crucial in a global warming and acid rain. And because of that, CNG has reduced pollution in our cities. Okay, question number 4, you have to compare here LPG and wood as fuel. So the first difference is LPG does not cause pollution on combustion because it is a cleaner fuel than wood, because wood, if they burn, they will pollute air on its combustion. Okay, LPG, have you seen the smoke outside of the gas flame? No. Why? Because it is a cleaner fuel and it not produce smoke. But in case of wood, it produces smoke. LPG is liquid fuel, means liquefied petroleum gas. So we have to pressurize that gas, so it will convert into a liquid state. So it, because of that, it is a liquid fuel. You might be confused with the kerosene and LPG, but LPG, here it is liquefied petroleum gas, that's why it is liquid, and wood, it is a solid fuel. LPG, it has a more caloric value, that is 55,000 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, what is caloric value? The energy that is produced by complete combustion of fuel, that is its caloric value. Okay, and wood, it has a less calorific value, that is 17,000 kilojoule per kg. LPG, it can be easily transported as it is stored in the cylinders, and wood, it can't be transported easily like LPG fuel. So write down this comparison in your notebook. Question number 5, give reason. First is, water is not used to control fires involving electrical equipment. Why? Because water is a good conductor of electricity. If we pour water on the electric circuit, what will cause? That water act as a conductor of electricity. So instead of removing fire, it will help fire over there. Okay, and it may result in electric shocks to the person that trying to extinguish fire. And it is the major reason, that's why we cannot use water when the when to control the fires involving electrical equipment. Second is, means B, that is LPG is a better domestic fuel than wood. LPG, being a cleaner fuel than wood, doesn't release smoke and other pollutants. Wood, on the other hand, releases lot of smoke, fumes, polluting the atmosphere, causing pollution and leading to respiratory diseases. And hence, LPG is better domestic fuel than wood. Okay? Just we discussed in previous question also this answer. So write down. Question C is, paper by itself catch fire easily, whereas a piece of paper wrapped round or aluminium pipe does not. Because yes, the paper by itself catches fire easily because of its low ignition temperature, but the piece of paper that wrap around an aluminium pipe doesn't catch fire because aluminium is good conductor of electricity. While the paper wrap around an aluminium pipe result in an increase in ignition temperature. So there is a transfer of heat from paper to aluminium pipe. Hence, it doesn't catch fire. So its a major reason is ignition temperature. And the because ignition temperature is vary, so paper get fire easily than the piece of paper which is wrapped inside the aluminium foil. Question 6, make a label diagram of a candle flame. So the first bluish color is outer zone or the hottest part. Why it is bluish in color? Because it is, this flame is due to complete combustion. This one is moderately hot, which is middle zone and in which there is a partial combustion. The last one is, or inside of it is a least hot, okay, and it is innermost zone of unburned wax vapor, and that's why it is somewhat blackish in color, okay, and it is a wax candle. So it is a label diagram of a candle flame. 7. Name the unit in which the calorific value of a fuel is expressed. The value, the unit is kilojoules per kilogram. Okay. Question number 8. Explain how CO2 is able to control fire. Okay. So CO2 is being heavier than oxygen. It covers the fire like a blanket and cuts off the contact between oxygen and fuel. In cylinder, CO2 is kept in a liquid form. Okay, when released, so how CO2 converts into liquid form? That has to press or pressurize CO2 gas, so it will converts into a liquid form. Okay, same like LPG. So in cylinder, CO2 is kept in the liquid form. When released, it expands enormously. This brings down the temperature of the fuel, which helps in controlling the fire. Okay, so CO2 means carbon dioxide. It covers the fire like a blanket and cuts off the contact between oxygen and fuel. Question number 9. It is difficult to burn a heap of green leaves, but dry leaves catch fire easily. Explain. A heap of green leaves contain, what is there in the green leaves? A lot of moisture, and because of that its ignition temperature is high. Why? Because water is there, moisture means it has a water content. So because of that water content, the green leaves has high ignition temperature and therefore it does not catch fire easily. But the dry leaves, there is no moisture content, so their ignition temperature is lower, okay, and therefore it catch fire easily. Getting? Okay. Question number 10. Which zone of flame does a goldsmith use for melting gold and silver? Why? Tell me which one. They have to melt the metal. So melting metal require high temperature. So in which zone of a flame there is high temperature is there? Yes, obvious, the outermost zone. So a goldsmith uses the outermost zone of a flame, which is non-luminous, to melt gold and silver, as it is the hottest zone of the flame having more temperature. Okay. Question number 11. In an experiment, 4.5 kilojoule, okay, of a fuel was completely burned. The heat produced was measured to be 180,000 kilojoule. Calculate the calorific value of the fuel. So calorific value, there is one formula, that heat produced by 4.5 kilojoule of fuel is 180,000 kilojoule. So calorific value of a fuel can be measured in terms of heat produced upon amount of fuel. So how much heat produced? 180,000. And this heat produced by the combustion of how much fuel? That is 4.5 kilojoule. So now calculate this, okay, you will get this answer. So heat produces 180,000 kilojoule and amount of fuel that is burned, that is 4.5 kgs. Okay, so calculate this and write your answer. Question number 12. Can the process of rusting be called combustion? Discuss. Okay, so answer is no. The process of rusting, we not that called it as combustion. Why? Because rusting is an exothermic process. Exo means heat is liberated during rusting. Okay. On the other hand, combustion is a chemical process in which substance reacts with oxygen to release energy in the form of heat or light. So combustion and rusting, these two are different process. Getting? During exothermic process, heat is liberated, but for the combustion we need to provide heat to that. Okay, so here rusting and combustion are two different process. Question 3 is, Abida and Ramesh were doing an experiment in which water was to be heated in a beaker. Abida kept the beaker near the wick in the yellow part of the candle. Ramesh kept the beaker in the outermost part of the flame, whose water will get heated in a shorter time. So tell me, whose water will get heated in a shorter time? Obvious, Ramesh. Why? Because Ramesh is using the flame which is outermost part flame. So it is more hot than the inside flame which used by Abida. Okay, so Ramesh, the water placed in the outermost part of the flame will be heated in a short time, since it is a non-luminous flame and is regarded as hottest part of the flame. So Ramesh beaker will be heated first. However, Abida, who placed the beaker in the luminous flame, that is yellow flame, is comparatively less hot. Okay, so thank you for watching this question answer session. Repeat this session, try to write the answers in your own language or in your own concept that you have understood. Okay, write down this, repeat this. Thank you so much by watching this whole session, that is chapter number 6. Up to that, bye.